half in the bag.
Kevin James is a poor man's hobo.
Yeah, I know. It's crazy that we're so busy, especially considering the fact that VCRs are a completely dead and outdated technology that no one uses anymore, but... yeah, I would say we're booked solid till the end of the year. I could try next year. Yeah, I know you don't want to wait that long. Look, let me look into this and I'll get back to you, okay? All right, bye.
Who was that?
Who do you think it was, Jay? It was a customer. He wants his VCR fixed right away. I had to tell him, you know, we're booked solid through December.
Mike, it's not December anymore.
What?
No, you idiot. You forgot to flip the calendar. Which means... Fuck you, it's January! Fuck you, it's January. It's the most magical time of the year. You know what that means.
It means it's time for Hollywood to take out their garbage.
That's right, Mike. They use our own neighborhood movie theaters to dump their waste.
I feel just like someone on a boat underneath Dave Matthews Band's tour bus.
What movies do we have to look forward to in January?
Oh, not much, Jay, but boy, oh boy, are there a lot. Yeah, 2014 is shaping up to be a great year.
Mm. Oh, wow, business is booming, too.
Hello? Thank you.
Who was that?
That was Mr. Plinkett's lawyer. He was just calling to remind him about the meeting he has with him tomorrow. He said he's planning to discuss details of the case, as well as give him his cash settlement from the city of Milwaukee. You know, the one they're giving him for tearing down his historic house.
He said all that?
Yeah.
Hmm. Well, I guess we better tell... Oh, right, he died.
Oh, so that's what the smell is.
Yeah, I thought it was you.
I thought it was me, too. I haven't showered since today.
Well, what are we gonna do? How are we gonna convince Plinkett's lawyer that he's not dead long enough for us to cash that check?
Jay, we're movie guys, right? Well, a certain movie comes to mind where all the main actors pretend that another actor isn't lifeless and dead the whole movie.
Oh, Cop Out with Bruce Willis.
Oh, no, actually, I was talking about Weekend at Bernie's 2.
Oh. Mike, this plan is so crazy.
Half in the bag.
I'd buy that for a dollar.
Hello, hello. I've been on hold for 10 minutes. Listen, I'm looking for something to prop up a large elderly man for a trip to his lawyer's office. Oh, a wheelchair. That's actually a pretty good idea. He is elderly. You see, I was going to go with a complicated system of ropes and pulleys and kind of make it look like he was walking, but a wheelchair makes perfect sense. Now listen, do you have anything to mask a very terrible odor? Kind of like the odor of a body decomposing. Like I'm looking for some kind of a cream or a salve, you know, that I could have Jay rub all over his naked body.
Ask him about the smell.
I just asked him about the smell. I'm talking to the guy now.
It smells like a dead body back there.
Yeah, I know it smells like a dead body. That's because there is a dead body back there, genius.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, about the salve. Walmart, I'll call you back.
Hello, officer dead body in the back. I mean, yeah. Officer police officer man.
Yeah.
There's definitely not a dead body in the back. I don't know why that slipped out. Can we help you with something unrelated to dead bodies?
Yeah, nothing. We can't help you with a dead body if that's what you're here for.
Yeah, because there's definitely not a dead body.
You need
there.
A VCR fix?
We can do that. That has nothing to do with dead bodies.
You need to watch a police training tape or something? I'm not saying you need training. I'm just saying maybe you do.
He looks like he might need training.
He might. I don't. Maybe he's not. Yeah. Oh, can we help you?
Yeah, the sulfur factory across the street's been complaining about a smell coming from your repair shop.
What kind of smell could possibly come from our repair shop?
They say it smells like a dead body.
That's horseshit, sir, to be honest. To be frank with you, that's horseshit.
Frankly, I'm starting to question your intelligence, officer.
What we do here is we fix VCRs and we occasionally talk about movies.
Oh, movies. I love movies.
Oh, really? What's your favorite movie?
My being a cop, my favorite movie is Howard the Duck.
Well, that is a very good movie, but since you're a cop, I assume you've seen the original RoboCop.
I don't know what that has to do with being a cop, but of course I've seen it.
Do you want to sit down and talk about RoboCop with us?
That sounds like a great idea.
It's much funner to talk about RoboCop than it is to talk about dead bodies in the back of our VCR repair shop.
I can't believe we distracted this dumb asshole.
Officer?
My name is Rich Kozlowski.
Rich, what, how,
this guy you've never met before?
Yeah, I know.
That's weird.
Oh, whatever.
You had arrested me for public drunkenness.
Public nudity and drunkenness.
Maybe about 10 years ago. And
okay.
While I was in the tank, you gave me a copy of RoboCop 2.
Mm, okay. What are the other big ones that haven't been remade yet?
We're due for a Police Academy remake.
Do you find those movies offensive?
I find them very accurate.
Mm. Was your time in the Police Academy just as wacky?
Well, there were more horrors.
What?
Does the real Police Academy contain as many boner jokes?
It contains more boners. I don't know about jokes, though.
Okay.
So boners and whores.
Yes.
All that's happening at
sometimes the, just boners.
Oh. At the Police Academy that you trained at?
Yes.
And what Police Academy was that?
I trained at Police Academy 7.
Oh, okay.
Well, it's been fun talking RoboCop with you boys, but... Yeah, I really should get back to investigating that suspicious dead body smell.
Hey, officer, I know that the last thing you want to hear is that they took a perfectly awesome action movie and dumbed it down into PG-13 cash grab, especially something like RoboCop.
But would you like to spend $60 and go see it with us anyway?
Yeah, sure, why not? I'll give Hollywood my money so they can keep churning out more crap that I'll hate.
Let's go.
All right, yeah.
Half in the bag.
I'd buy that for a dollar.
Oh, hi. Welcome to Half in the Bag. I'm Jake.
And I'm Mike.
Who are you talking to?
And we just saw the new RoboCop.
Yeah. Well, it's confirmed. Howard the Duck is still my favorite movie. What? What?
What's wrong with this guy?
I don't know. But I'm drinking a cherry teeny.
So the CG on the robot hands playing the guitar in the one scene in the movie, I thought that looked really great.
That was all CG?
That was all CG. Even the guitar was CG.
Oh my god, that looks so fucking good. The guy who did that should really be given a raise.
Yeah.
What's the problem?
What's that smell?
Oh, that's the dead body in the back.
Oh, I forgot about the dead body in the back.
All right, I'm supposed to be here to check on that suspicious smell. I forgot about that, too. I'm so glad you guys reminded me. I was just about to leave.
Oh, shit, what are we gonna do?
I don't know. What? What's that?
Whoa. Oh, what the fuck is happening?
God. Oh, my God, what's that?
Where did he go?
Oh my god! I'm on the Howard the Duck planet! I wonder what kind of crazy adventures I'll get into now! Ow.
Half in the bag.
Where's the beef?
Come in.
Hi, Mr. Rosenblatt. I'm Jay. I'm your 3 o'clock appointment.
Ah, yes. Mr. Harry S. Plinkett versus the city of Milwaukee.
Mm-hmm.
And where is Mr. Plinkett? Are you a relative of his?
No, I'm not. I'm just a friend, but he said it's okay for me to deal with this matter. He wrote this note.
I'm afraid I'll have to speak with Mr. Plinkett personally, unless, of course, you have power of attorney.
No, I don't. I only have the power of Grayskull. Mike, bring in Mr. Plinkett!
Hello! I'm Mr. Plinkett! As you can see, I'm still alive! And I give Jay and Mike permission of attorney! Ho 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 ho! I'll sign any paperwork you ask me to sign. Oh, my glasses fell off. I'm clumsy, but I'm still alive. Why do my sunglasses
stick? I told you we should have used fucking glue.
Well, I tried, and it wouldn't stick to the skull, to the exposed, rotting skin tissue.
He's had some difficulties lately. We're his caregivers, and, he's feeling a bit under the weather recently. He's looking a little pale, you know. It's some of the medication he's been on.
Sir, I've seen Weekend at Bernie's, and you are no Andrew McCarthy. That is clearly a dead body. And I'm calling the police.
Excuse me.
This has been a horrible, horrible failure.
Don't worry, Jay. If we were able to fool the lawyer into thinking Mr. Plinkett was still alive, we can fool the police too. Seen any good movies lately?
Gentlemen, the police are on their way. I suggest you get that corpse out of my office this instant.
But it's not a corpse. It's Mr. Plinkett. And he's still alive.
Mike, we're not fooling anyone. The truth is, sir, we were just trying to get the cash settlement for Mr. Plinkett's lawsuit. His house was unfairly torn down, and then he died eating too many cheeseburgers.
That's right, Jay. Plus, he lived in our VCR repair shop for a whole week, and he smelled real bad. So we feel that we deserve all this money.
You two don't deserve diddly squat.
What?
You fools. I've been alive this whole time. My identical twin brother, Barry S. Plinkett, kidnapped me from the bingo hall months ago and stole my identity in an attempt to get my money. But then he accidentally died eating cheeseburgers, I guess. I just escaped from his basement where he had me tied up. Please don't point out the irony in this matter.
Well, the real Mr. Plinkett, I'm glad you're here so I can finally close this case. The city of Milwaukee is prepared to offer you $1.6 million in restitution for the loss of your historic house.
Oh, that sounds great, but I think I'd like to go with our second option.
Oh my God, what is the second option?
The city has offered to completely rebuild Mr. Plinkett's house from scratch. All the debris reassembled, but in a different location.
What?
They estimate this will cost $1.5 million, which is cost beneficial to the taxpayers, so they're pushing for that one.
No, Mr. Plinkett, no, don't do that.
No, that's a terrible idea. With $1.6 million, you could buy a brand new home and have tons of money left over.
You boys just don't understand. I've got a lot of great memories associated with that house. It's the place where I was born 100 years ago. Why, it's the house I lived in with my sweet wife until she died in 1933. She's buried in the backyard. Oh, I forgot. Well, now I guess she's buried under the freeway. Whoops. But that place is a part of me, and I want it back, no matter the cost or the logic.
Great, great. Now do me a favor and get that dead fucking body out of my office.
Oh, shit.
Can you get it through here?
Get him to help. This is his fucking problem, too.
What? What's wrong?
I'm trying to get the body out.
What are you doing with my fucking brother here? Get him out. Where's...
I'm trying.
I'm stuck.
Well, the chair's stuck.
Drop them on the floor. Give me the body.
Plinkett. His pants have fallen down. This is disgraceful.
Oh, I'm going to get the chair out of here and get him in the chair.
Sorry.
Get him in the chair.
I'll take the wheelchair out separately.
Put the corpse in the chair and then we can get the whole thing out at once. What are you doing? Where's his hat? Don't forget his hat.
Jay, listen. Oh.
Jesus Christ.
Where does this go?
All of his clothes have come off now. All of his clothes. This is just Rococulus.
Where does this arm go?
Oh, God. His arm has come off.
I gotta put an arm on my brother.
Would it be all right if we left him here?
No.
All right. I figured I'd ask it. I figured. All right.
Oh, no, the door is shut.
Trying to get this part.
I gotta get the door. Get that chair out of the way.
Okay. I got it free.
Okay.
Here, listen, I can't reach that. I can't get past this chair, so I'm going to toss him to you.
All right.
Here we go. I'm sorry. I'm really, I got poor aim.
Just start a fire. We'll cremate him. We'll cremate him right now. Toss him to me, and I'll get him out of here. Throw him.
Okay.
He's too heavy. Help, I'm trapped under my dead.
Toss him back.
Jay, this is becoming a farce. It's really.
Oh my God.
Mr. Plinkett, get up. I'm going to attempt to toss him.
I've got an arm.
Half in the bag.
I like to eat cheeseburgers.
Yes, thank you.
Boy, those events at the lawyer's office sure didn't go like I had hoped.
No, they didn't, Jay.
Half in the bag.
Hi, do you guys fix VCRs?
Oh my God, it stinks back there. Mr. Plinkett smells horrible.
Yeah, I know. Plus he snores too. He's also not a very good cuddler.
Hey, since the city is paying to rebuild Mr. Plinkett's house, why are we still letting him stay here? We don't stand to gain anything from this.
You're right, Jay. It's a very good question. You know what we need? Is another brand new money-making scheme.
How about we try running a legitimate business?
No! You know, I've been thinking about it, and the biggest money-making schemes around right now are turning comic books into movies.
Hey, you're right! If some comic book movie ideas were just original scripts today, they'd be laughed at. But because the source material is a comic book, they're treated with legitimacy for some reason, even though comics were originally just trash whipped up to sell ads to children.
That's right, Jay. You know, I've had an idea for a comic book. I would call it Horse Ninja.
That's so stupid.
Yeah, it's about a racehorse who tramples an enchanted ninja and then absorbs all of his ninja powers. I figured Jet Li could play the ninja, and Sarah Jessica Parker could play the horse.
Oh my God, that sounds like a great idea to make some money, but how do we sell the movie rights?
Well, Jay, we gotta turn it into a comic book first, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. Come on, Jay, we're going to New York City, where comic books are made.
Hi, are you a comic book man?
Why, yes I am.
Hey Jay, this guy looks familiar.
Oh yeah.
Hey comic book man, did you once own a comic book store in Milwaukee?
I did.
So Rich, what did you think of The Amazing Spider-Man?
Better luck next time?
I remember him now. Hey, didn't we shoot you to death with laser guns?
Oh!
That's not exactly how it happened.
Again. Here, let me try some.
Okay.
Really got him that time.
Yeah.
In any case, yeah, I used to own that shop, but, you know, I gave that all up. I decided I want to pursue my dream of becoming a comic book artist. Real big shot in the industry. And I made it, too.
Fortunately, they have me drawing Little Orphan Annie. The black one.
Well, anyway, we came all the way here to pitch you our comic book idea. We want you to draw it. And you gotta hurry, too, because I gotta sell the rights to the movie companies.
What's it called?
It's called Horse Ninja.
What's it about?
It's called Horse Ninja.
Okay, I'll do it. But, you know, my wrist is really starting to hurt. I want to take a break first. Do you mind if we catch a double feature?
As long as you draw our comic book for us.
What movies are we going to see?
Oh, yeah, we're going to go see movies. Let's see Transcendence and Spider-Man 2.
So, why did we come all the way to Milwaukee to talk about those movies?
Who cares? Let's head back to your office so you can finish that Horse Ninja comic for me. I can't wait till Alex Kurtzman and Robert Orci write another terrible screenplay.
Guys, I've got a confession to make.
What's that?
I've already made the Horse Ninja comic book.
What? How is that possible?
You see, Mike, you've stumbled upon the last unmade idea. A racehorse possessed by the soul of an enchanted ninja seeking revenge upon an evil corporation hell-bent on weaponizing horse sperm.
That's a good idea.
That's pretty fucking good.
It's the last idea in the world, and it's all mine. I'm gonna take this shit to Michael Bay or Mark Webb or Brett Ratner, and we're gonna make it into a fucking movie. A god-awful fucking movie that people are gonna see in droves. Nothing can stop me now. Soon, you will see the world as I see it, as a fat schlub with terrible ideas. Now my terrible ideas can become larger, dumber, even more terrible ideas. Soon the world will know my wrath. The standards in Hollywood are so low right now that even I can make a movie, a fucking Horse Ninja movie. And we're gonna shove Scarlett Johansson in there. Just because, man, who gives a fuck? We're just gonna shove her in the movie and we're gonna give her random lines. Her name's gonna be Love Interest and she's gonna fuck a horse.
Not so fast, comic book artist man.
I wanted the Klingon phaser.
Jay, it's called a Klingon disruptor, not a phaser.
Whatever.
You two do know those are just toys, right?
Fire! Got him. Look at the way his skin is melting off his face.
Half in the bag.
I put pizza rolls in my VCR so I could watch them on TV, but it didn't work.
Oh, hi.
Do you ever do Taibo?
One, two, three, four, five.
Do you remember that fad of kickboxing?
Billy Blanks, right? Was that his
name?
I never did Taibo, no.
Yeah. I didn't either.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Half in the bag.
I bet my wife at the casino and won.
Hey everyone, I'm Mike.
And I'm Jay, and we're here in Daytona Beach for spring break 2012.
That's right, Jay. We're taking a break from fixing VCRs to bring you a very special episode of Half in the Bag, which is sponsored by Karpinski Funeral Homes, crossing the bridge together.
We're also sponsored by Quality Caskets, affordable prices, quality craftsmanship.
And McDonald's, I'm loving it.
Hey, Mike, before we hit up the beach, do you want to go see some movies?
Sure do, Jay. What a great way to spend 4 hours indoors when it's sunny and warm out.
What?
What movies would you like to see, Jay?
Let's go see A Million Ways to Die in the West, because of Family Guy, yo.
No, I heard that movie's terrible. Let's also see X-Men Days of Future Past.
Okay.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
He had to stand on a small box to be almost as tall as me. You know, Jay, it sure is great being away from the VCR repair shop and our miserable lives.
That's right, Mike. What do you say we go hit up the beach? Spring break! Oh. You okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm all right, yeah.
Jesus Christ.
I know. It's...
None of it was real, was it?
Oh.
All we have is terrible movies, Jay.
Half in the bag. These jerks can't fix a VCR right.
Jesus Christ, it's like a chicken with his head cut off. Oh, thank Christ. Ah, back to work. Oh. Lightning fast VCR repair, how can I help you?
Yes. Do you still fix VCRs?
Yes, we do. And no, our refrigerator isn't running. I stopped chasing it weeks ago.
Good. Well, I have a broken VCR. My kids say that I should get a Blu-ray player, but I like all my tapes. Can you fix it?
Sure, we could fucking fix it. Do you have fucking money?
Well, yes. Do you make house calls?
Sure, we make house calls. Sometimes for a very long time. What's your address?
We'll be over in 5 minutes.
Okay, good. I'll see you then. Bye.
Bye. Jay, get out of the bathroom. We got a job.
Come in. Are you the VCR repairman?
Well, it's questionable if I'm a man, but we do repair VCRs.
Great! There's my VCR.
What's the fucking problem with it?
Mike, what's with the swearing? Do you have fucking Tourette's?
No, fuck you, motherfucker!
It just stops working after 20 minutes, and it ejects the tape all by itself.
All by itself, you say? Mm-hmm. Have you consulted a priest? It's very likely that this VCR is possessed by a demonic entity. As seen in the current film, Deliver Us From Evil.
Hey, Mike. It sounds like a faulty eject switch on the circuit board. That takes 5 minutes to repair.
Ma'am, it'll take 16 hours to fix this VCR.
Oh, what is your hourly rate?
$9,000 an hour.
You're being silly. I'll give you $20. I can pick up a working VCR at a thrift store for $5, but I like this one. My late husband gave it to me for my birthday in 1980.
Your late husband, you say? Mm-hmm. Have you considered the fact that it's his spirit trapped in that VCR? You know, ma'am, I happen to be a licensed exorcist, and for a nominal fee, I can exorcise his spirit from the VCR, sending him off into heaven, preventing his soul from being trapped and tormented in the depths of hell for eternity, as seen in the current film, Tammy.
No, it's just that it's not working. I'm going to go to the market, and I'll be back in an hour, and I expect that VCR to be working. I would like to watch my tapes.
$20? This is bullshit.
Yeah.
Well, Jay, I think we should talk about movies now.
Yeah, let's talk about movies before that mean old lady gets back.
Jay, are you saying you want to murder her?
Yes.
Hey, before we start talking about these movies, and before we fix her VCR, let's make long-distance phone calls on her telephone line. Hello, China? Yeah, I hear everyone there is watching Transformers 4. Yeah, can you guys stop watching our movies? You're ruining them. You're making us make bad movies. Okay, thanks, bye. You know, that phone call just cost us 100,000 China bucks.
Did you just know that number off the top of your head?
Mm-hmm. It was my old cell phone number. Share fitness, a new attitude? Jim Barton's The Job Interview and You. Mail to the Chief, starring Randy Quaid.
Oh my God, my hamster loves that video.
Sheesh, it's no wonder this lady's VCR was ejecting these tapes all by itself. These movies stink.
Yeah, well, the last tape was in there for over 30 minutes, so I think it's okay now.
Hello, boys. How's the fixing coming?
Oh, just great. We actually just finished it.
Everything's working fine.
Oh, well, I do appreciate your hard work and your honesty. I have to put these things away before they melt. So please show yourself out. Okay, bye.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Huh. Well, I guess we fixed the VCR.
Yeah. So now we leave?
I think, yeah, this is the part where we leave.
Oh. Okay.
It's so weird.
This is weird.
You're right, Jay. Usually when we go to fix a VCR, something strange happens.
Yeah, this was just like a normal business transaction.
Nothing weird happened at all.
I guess let's head back.
All right. Damn it! We were too late to assassinate our past selves!
The time vortex is unpredictable. They could have left hours ago.
Damn it! Looks like we repaired the VCR already.
Our only option is to destroy the tape then. When Carol watches that old sci-fi film, she gets intrigued by human genetics, which causes her to invest in a fledgling company called Biotron.
And Biotron becomes so successful and Carol so wealthy that she's appointed the CEO. Under her leadership, Biotron then begins their horrible human genetics experimentations.
Which creates the first army of super soldiers, leading to the Great Eugenics War of 2035.
Billions dead. I've seen so much. Wait, why are we telling each other this? We already know all this information. What is this, X-Men Days of Future Past? Fuck it. Jay, we've got to find that tape and destroy it. Humanity is counting on us. Is this it? It's in this cookie jar. It's in this cookie jar. I know it. I know it. I know it. Oh, shit.
It wasn't in the cookie jar.
Keep looking! Maybe it's in the couch. Under the couch. Look under the couch.
Damn it! It's not here.
Fuck!
It must be somewhere else.
Hey, wait. Why don't we just kill Carol instead?
Oh, yeah, that's a much better idea. Ah!
It is done, dear leader. excellent future Mike and Jay, I would assume that my past self is unharmed and that the timeline protected.
Yes, my queen. All sectors of the new United Territories bow to your power.
Oh, you two have done well. Since your re-education, you have been two of my most loyal sellouts. When the new age is upon us, you will be spared from vaporization.
Thank you, my queen.
Return to the future, and prepare for the next phase of the great eugenics war.
Yes, my queen.
Half in the bag. Wait a minute. Wait, where am I?
Go via just recorder.
Mike, I just repaired that.
Hey, have you noticed that it's been smelling really great in the back room lately? What gives?
Well, Mike, don't you remember? Mr. Plinkett moved out a week ago.
Oh, that's right. The government rebuilt his house after illegally demolishing it to make room for a freeway.
That's right, Mike. Hey, your brain remembers things.
Treat.
Lightning fast VCR repair.
Yeah, little lady. Can you fix my VCR?
Well, that's what we do at Lightning Fast VCR Repair.
Shut up and put the fat fuck on the phone. He's better at customer service, you lousy prick.
I'm sorry, who?
That greasy-haired motherfucker who looks like he fell out of a horse's ass.
Oh, Mike, it's for you.
Okay. How the fuck can I help you?
Yeah, it's me, Mr. Plinkett. I'm back.
I need you to come over to my brand new old house that they just fucking built.
And I want you to fix my goddamn useless piece of shit VCR again.
Your fucking VCR?
Well, it's not my goddamn fault. You're such a fucking incompetent prick when it comes to fixing shit.
Yeah, fuck you.
Fuck you too.
We'll be buying a little bit. You fuck!
We're back.
Good. Now get back to work. I still want my VCR fixed. I know we've had some setbacks, but I want to watch my Night Court tape sometime before I die.
All right, sir. Can you tell us where the VCR is located?
You forgot?
It's right over there where it always is.
Oh my fuck.
So you mean to tell me that the government took the time to reassemble your entire house from pulverized debris, but they couldn't just give you a working VCR and TV?
Exactly as it was. That was the agreement.
Well, okay, as long as you're still willing to give us $50 an hour to repair it.
$500 an hour. Our rate is $500 an hour. He forgot the zero.
Look, just fix my VCR. I'm going to the store to buy anal lube, a pack of razor blades, and a Bible. And when I get back, I expect my VCR to be fixed, so I go watch my Night Court tape while shoving lubed up Bible pages into my asshole while cutting myself jerking off to Richard Mole. Good day to you, sirs.
Would you like some hand sanitizer?
Yeah, do you have any?
No.
Well, Mike, I think we have two options here.
Yeah.
We can either forget everything that we just heard or kill ourselves.
Oh, kill ourselves.
No, okay.
But first, let's talk about Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
Okay.
Now, these are chairs?
It's been a while since we've been here. I don't remember.
Okay.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's something like this. Well, let me set this BR down and I try to get in this chairy. Well, Jay, I think that was the best movie discussion that we've ever had.
Probably not. Hey, did you notice when we were pulling up that Plinkett's house was rebuilt on the edge of a cliff?
I did, Jay. Especially since the address that he gave us was Cliff.
That's weird. I wonder why they'd do that.
Don't know. You hear that?
What?
What is that?
Sounds like a truck backing up.
Yeah.
kind of construction sounds. It's getting louder. They're coming from that direction.
Oh my god.
What is that, some kind of a tube?
Oh my god. It smells a little like toxic waste.
Well, this is a dilemma. And considering the fact that Plinkett's house is on the edge of a cliff, would it be fair to call the ending of this episode a mystery?
Half in the bag.
I don't know what planet I'm on.
Hello and welcome to Half in the Bag. I'm Jay.
And I'm Jay. Hey Jay, do you think it's smart to sit here and talk about movies while that pipe dumps in tons of noxious chemicals and gases into this house?
Oh, I completely forgot about it actually.
It's everywhere and it smells like cancer.
Should we investigate what's happening?
Maybe we should do something about it. Till next time. Ooga chaka,
ooga, ooga, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga. Half in the bag.
Calgon, take me away.
Linklater's poetic dialogue about a boring kid mumbling should be compared to the greatest works of literature. In fact, if I could, I would take a shit on every book ever written, because Boyhood is the best fucking thing ever!
Hey there, son. Why all the yelling?
Oh, he's just very passionate about how much he loves Boyhood.
Oh, Boyhood? The new Richard Linklater film? Oh, that film's fucking amazing!
Fuck yeah, it is! Linklater makes Truffaut look like an asshole!
Yeah, fuck Truffaut!
Yeah!
Yeah, fuck yeah! Boyhood's so fucking awesome! Hey, Mr. Construction Worker, it sounds like you like movies. We just saw two new ones. You want to sit down and talk to us about them?
Fuck yeah!
I want to talk more about how awesome Boyhood is. I want to talk about how awesome Boyhood is!
Oh, geez, I totally forgot why I came in here. Yeah, you guys can't be in this house.
What? Why?
Because it's being used as a repository for chlorofluorobenzene, a highly toxic gas.
But this is somebody's house.
Don't look at me. The way I understand it, the chemical company down the way, they can't dump their toxic waste into the air or the sea. But due to a legal loophole, they can dump it into a private residence.
Is that why the city rebuilt Plinkett's house right here?
Yeah, some corrupt politician built that into the contract for this place. Yeah, dirty bastards taking money under the table from the chemical company.
Damn corruption. Damn deadly gas. If only we had real superheroes like the Ninja Turtles.
Wait a minute, Jay. Maybe breathing in all this gas will give us superpowers. Then we could fight the corrupt politicians and the chemical companies on our own.
Yeah, well, let's just sit here and breathe in these toxic chemicals and see what happens.
That sounds good.
Well, good luck breathing in all these carcinogenic gases. I'm gonna go outside and have a cigarette.
Believe, Mike, believe.
I can feel the superpowers taking hold already.
I think it's working.
Half in the bag.
I'm trying to find my fleshlight with the flashlight.
All right. Got it all duct taped up. No more deadly gas is coming into this house, Jay.
Oh, thank God, because I was legally dead for 6 minutes.
Me too. But I wish it was longer.
Well, at least now we don't have to worry about this place getting all stinky.
Hey, speaking of stinky, let's talk about all the films that we saw this year.
Okay. What do you have there?
Oh, why, it's a bottle opener. High quality bottle opener.
Yeah?
See that?
It worked and everything.
I know. It has some writing on it, but that's inconsequential.
Sure.
The good new David Fincher film.
My God! The noxious gas is backing up into our Biotron waste disposal facility! This whole place is gonna blow!
Half in the bag.
I have so many problems. I have to take so many pills for my problems.
So I was thinking of getting rid of my beard.
I didn't know you had a beard. What's her name?
What? No, my facial hair.
Oh.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Oh.
Mr. Plinkett, where have you been? We haven't seen you in a really long time.
I've been in the hospital for 3 weeks. Apparently you can't eat the type of nuts you buy at the hardware store.
Huh. Well, I for one forgot all about you.
I haven't forgotten, Mike. In fact, I started writing a book about missing Plinkett. That's called Gone Grandpa.
Oh, that sounds intriguing. In fact, it sounds quite similar to the book by Gillian Flynn called Gone Girl.
Did you say Gillian Flynn?
Gillian, as in Gilligan's Island.
So her name is Gillian Flynn, not Gillian Flynn.
It's not, no.
Okay.
We're very clear on that now.
Yeah.
But speaking of that book by Gillian Flynn, have you seen the new movie Annabelle?
I have. I've also seen Gone Girl, which the screenplay for that was also written by Gillian Flynn.
Oh, interesting.
I mean Gillian Flynn.
Did you know the lead actress in Annabelle? Her real name is Annabelle. Did you know Gillian Flynn once owned a possessed doll?
This is amazing. Maybe we should talk about these films that we've seen.
All right.
That's fine. You guys do that. I'm gonna go drink some Pepto-Bismol.
Why is he walking like he just ate hardware store nuts?
Because he just ate hardware store nuts.
Oh. Oh. Oh, there's the Annabelle doll. So, Mike, do you think they'll make a sequel to Gillian Flynn's movie Gone Girl and call it Goner Girl?
I don't know, Jay, but I sure am looking forward to a sequel to Annabelle called Annabeller.
And I can't wait for the sequel to The Equalizer. It's going to be called The Equalizerer.
And hopefully someday they'll make another Maze Runner film. Maze Runner 2, The Amazementing. Oh my God, what's happening?
Is this an earthquake?
Oh my God! Oh,
Jesus Christ! Oh.
What's going on? Is it an earthquake?
What is this madness?
I don't know, but the house is shaking violently as if some kind of pressure is building up.
Oh no! I think I'm gonna shit my pants! Oh, nuts!
That's a lot of nuts.
That's what she said.
Whoa! Oh, Jesus! Whoa! Oh my God! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
This cliff is so fucking long! Plinkett, don't knock over the cabinet!
I hope it doesn't fall over!
Oh my God!
Half in the bag.
Apes in outer space.
God, I think I'm getting seasick.
Excuse me, J-Lo, that's lake sick. We're on Lake Michigan. And from what I can tell, the current has pulled us out pretty far, too.
Oh, whatever. I hate water. That's why I don't bathe.
Ew. Well, don't worry, Jay. This water is much less scary than the ocean. Lake Michigan's deepest point is only 922 feet, which means we're much less likely to drown in water that comparatively shallow.
Oh, fuck!
What's this?
It's like being on a Carnival cruise line, just much safer.
Hey, Mike, did you know Mr. Plinkett used to be a hot air balloon pilot? Or racer, or whatever the fuck you call it.
I did not know that, Jay. I wonder how that'll come into play later.
It's true. It's all true. My secret past as a hot air balloon pilot is finally out. Ugh, all this damn water, it's flushing out things I hid in my basement years ago. Old photos, cat coffins, thousands of copies of E.T. on Atari.
I wish I was dead. Oh God, I hope the bugs eat me alive.
You know, I think my old hot air balloon is down there too, all folded up. I used to be the best hot air balloon piloteer of all time. Even wanted to branch out into dirigibles. But that career got cut short after the Hindenburg.
Mr. Plinkett, you crashed the Hindenburg?
Oh, no, I just watched. I was the guy yelling, "Oh, the humanity!" Seeing that really scarred me though. Because of that, I gave up hot air ballooning, and because of Prohibition, I started selling bathtub gin. That's where the real money's at.
Hey, Mike, if we're stranded out on Lake Michigan, how are we gonna watch and talk about movies?
I don't know, Jay. I guess we'll just have to talk about politics and religion instead.
Oh, that reminds me. Oh, God. Here. I paid $9,000 for this. Yeah, I went to buy some booze off of a bootlegger, you know, because Prohibition's still on.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
And that jerk on the street ripped me off. I don't know what anybody's supposed to do with that many drink coasters, but enjoy. I'm gonna go take a piss in Lake Michigan. Should make this water cleaner.
Jay, what is that?
It appears to be bootlegs of all the movies that are coming out over the next few months.
No kidding. Well, that's fucking convenient.
Yeah, look.
Interstellar? Oh, that's the new Christopher Nolan movie, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Well, let's watch that one first.
Okay.
I'm sure it's gonna look real good on this TV. You know, I shot at an IMAX.
But we don't have a DVD player.
Look, Jay. A DVD player has also washed up conveniently for us.
Oh, that's really convenient. Now we have a DVD player, so we can play our bootleg DVD of Interstellar on the TV.
Yeah, we can watch Christopher. Let's just talk about the movies, okay?
Okay.
So, Jay, do you think Interstellar will sink or swim with audiences?
Well, Mike, it's funny you should say that, because we're sinking!
Oh, my God! Water flew in my ear!
This is horribly inconvenient.
Half in the bag. Everybody do the Bartman. Remember that? Oh, fuck. Fuck wheelchairs.
Mike, I thought you said Lake Michigan was only 922 feet deep. We've been falling for hours.
That's because the house is filled with air. That's why we're taping up the windows, you fuck. It's to keep from drowning.
Do you really think some dollar store garbage bags are gonna keep out millions of pounds of water pressure?
Hey, so far it's working, motherfucker.
Hey, you just wanna talk about movies instead?
Okay.
Now.
Let's see what we got here. Well, Mike, those certainly were good movies.
That's right, Jay, they were. But don't get too used to it, because it's almost January, and you know what that means.
Oh, God. That's the time of year when movies hit rock bottom.
Hey, speaking of bottom...
Oh no, I'm a top, clearly.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about us hitting the bottom of the lake.
Half in the bag. Put it in my hobbit hole.
Is Percocet food?
It can be.
Is oxycodone food?
It can be.
Clozapine? Isn't that a drug for crazy people? I don't know what we're gonna do now, Jay, that this house is sitting on the bottom of a lake.
Yeah.
It's a good thing we put all these garbage bags over the windows. It's helping to keep all this water out.
Yeah, who would have thought that some duct tape and garbage bags would be able to withstand the water pressure of a gigantic lake?
You know, Jay, this whole sinking house saga of ours has gone on longer than a Peter Jackson Hobbit film.
Mm. Hey, speaking of The Hobbit, did you hear Kim Jong-un was threatening to bomb movie theaters that were playing The Interview?
Little does he know that movie theaters are already filled with bombs.
Speaking of bombs, do you want to watch The Hobbit Part 3 and talk about it?
I guess so. What else do we have to do down here?
It'll kill approximately 7 hours. Oh, there it is.
The Hobbit Part 3.
Disc 1.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus Christ. Put it in the player. Play.
How are we getting electricity down here?
Yeah. So they tried to do a Brady Bunch reunion, but everybody forgot that the dad was dead.
Oh, how embarrassing. Mr. Plinkett, you know how to use a computer?
Damn right I do. And I think I figured a way out of this bottom of the lake nonsense.
Oh, how's that?
Well, I heard you talking about bombs earlier, so I figured that an explosion ought to propel the house back up to the surface.
But how?
I posted on my blog that Kim Jong-un is a fat, cowardly, murderous pig fucker. I figure when that crippled, paranoid slob with the Three Stooges haircut hears that, why, he ought to... What?
Oh, dear God. Is that what I think it is?
It's working! It's working!